name is Phillip Michael Thomas. I'm an actor. Maybe you've seen me in motion pictures, possibly television or stage. I played a number of roles, ranging from doctors to Buffalo soldiers to the slick cop, Ricardo Tubbs on Miami Vice. Regardless of what role an actor plays, it requires an incredible amount of discipline, concentration, and other things that sometimes you can't even define. There are times when you get a role where it's easy, and other times when you gotta dig down deep, deep, deep inside yourself, and you come up with things that fascinate even you. I was very fortunate in the fact that I played such a role in a film called Death Drug. The character I play is Jesse Thomas. He was a budding musician. Bypass the objection, sometimes break the rules. Use the mountaintop, success, you got to use the master's tools. He had everything going for him. He had a budding career, a beautiful wife, and got a scholarship to a music conservatory. But he made one tragic mistake. He got involved with drugs. Whack. Sometimes it's called angel dust. This was a forerunner of what we now call crack. I tell you, this was one of the most incredible experiences of my acting career. I hope you'll enjoy the dramatization.
Top of the news tonight, another tragic death due to the killer drug, angel dust.
In Venice, 46-year-old Angelo Marchetti, reportedly an angel dust user, went berserk, attacking and injuring 8 skaters in an outdoor rink. In this exclusive Action Desk footage shot by one of our cameramen who was preparing a feature on the skaters, Marchetti began attacking the young people with a large board.
Okay, we're down here. Are we rolling? Stay away. Watch it. Stay away from me. This guy's got a board. Are we still rolling? Keep the camera rolling. Keep it rolling. Watch it. Somebody got to get him. Call the police. Where's the police? Quick. Get. There they are. Oh, they got him. They got him. Are we still rolling? Okay, we're down here live. We're watching this as it's actually happening, ladies and gentlemen. They've captured this madman, this crazy man. He's foaming at the mouth. We don't know what's wrong with him, but it appears that the police have him in hand right now, and it looks like they're going to take him away.
Okay.
We were a little concerned before because he came very, very close to hitting us with this large board that he has. And oh, he broke away. Please, somebody get him. He broke away. He's running away. Don't let him get it. Watch it. Oh, he got hit by the car. Oh, no.
Marchetti was pronounced dead on arrival at Venice Hospital. This tragic death brings the death toll associated with the killer drug angel dust to 19 for this year in the Los Angeles metropolitan area.
Base. It's over 15.
Jesse, are you through already?
Yeah, I just finished that installation at the laundromat. Anything else on tap?
Mr. Sims wants to talk to you.
Jesse.
Yeah?
Check with me when you come in.
Any problem?
Do you need some?
Yeah, only the ones you can't handle.
That'll be the day.
All right. Over 15 out. See you.
Sis?
What it is? Long day and no pay.
I heard that.
Hey, you want to bet 10 that Dallas beat the Rams by 11?
Are you serious? Not with the brothers we got in the backfield.
Hey, make it 100 and you're on.
No. Not in this life, baby. I'll check y'all fellas tomorrow.
All right, bro.
Hey, Mr. Sim.
Hey, Jesse. How's the music? Hey, listen. I got 3 new trainees, and they need some supervision on that new system. I'd like one of them to go with you tomorrow.
Sure thing. I could use the help.
Great. When you come in the morning, check the manifest.
Will do. I'll see you tomorrow.
Just today.
Mm-hmm.
I must be slipping.
Listen. Your mail's on the piano.
Oh, Jesse. Jesse? Mr. Curtis called from Crown Records about a 10 o'clock appointment on Saturday to talk about your demo tapes.
Did they say whether or not they listened to the tape?
Oh, I'm sure they did.
You think they liked it?
I'm sure they did. They are crazy if they didn't. Here you go.
Thank you, baby. Keep your fingers crossed on this one.
I always do.
Love you. Got accepted to the Conservatory of Music their next session.
Oh, baby, I'm so happy for you. Oh, this is what God. You wanted.
You know, I had completely forgotten all about this.
Well,
wow, Jesse Thomas is on his way in this world. This calls for celebration. Oh, I'm going to call Melvin and Judy, and we're going to celebrate. We're going to do town tonight.
Calm down. Now, what about this fabulous dinner I fixed you?
Oh, woman, you better get yourself ready to get out of here in 30 minutes.
All right, baby, this is your night.
Way home, y'all. Gotta listen to the girls. shake my booty at the disco.
Gassed up?
Yeah.
Don't stay away too long.
How's Jesse's father?
I don't know. They still don't speak.
What's happening, man?
Hey, Jesse, come on. I see you here trying to get high on that old burnout weed.
I ain't got no complaints, John.
Not with this. You can really get down, Jesse. This'll give you a high you won't soon forget.
Looks just like a regular cigarette to me.
I see. Man, this is the stick with the kick, the tower of power. This comes from the heavens above.
Look, quit the bull, Jonas, and tell me what it is.
It's dust, man. This is a sherb, coated from end to end with the juice. Now, one hit from this, baby, it's gonna put you in tune with some rhythms you ain't never knew existed.
Yeah? How much is it?
It's free. Come on, Jesse. We like your music, the songs you write. I mean, your music's out of this world.
Oh, you're all right, Jonas. You're all right.
Now you take this. All right? And you smoke it.
All right. Look, I'm going to have to get on out of here and play something for the folks.
All right.
Yeah, you're all right, man.
Make sure you smoke that sherm first chance you get.
All right. I'll catch you later.
All right.
Jesse, you are a genius.
I said you should have studied music in high school like I did.
How could I? Too busy keeping you out of trouble.
Oh, uh-huh. I heard that.
Yeah, I'm sure you heard it.
Hey, Mel. Why don't you and Judy get out on the dance floor and boogie?
Hey, come on, Melvin. Get him out here.
Come on, get on up, get down.
Oh, come on,
Melvin. Come on, man.
To the
okay, babe. That painting on the wall. It's got a nice vibration to it.
It's just a painting to me.
My name is Jesse Thomas, and I have a 10 o'clock appointment to see Mr. Curtis.
Mitchell! Dean!
Oh, hey, Dean, this is Jesse Thomas.
How you doing, Jesse?
I'm fine. How are you?
Really some good music you made.
Thank you. What do you mean, good, good? Hey, come on. We usually don't come in here on Saturday mornings. It's great.
Look here, we'd like to sign you with your company.
Yeah, look, we're going to book you on every concert, on every music special there is.
Mr. Curtis, I think you should take a look at this. I just got accepted to the Conservatory of Music the next session.
Conservatory? Oh, no. No, look, you can just forget about this conservatory. Hey, look, when you're gonna have so much promotion, you won't have time to breathe, much less go to school.
That's right, kid, you sign with us, you won't have no time to go to school.
And look,
after
you're gonna
you
be as big as Donna Summer at the Bee Gees.
I love it.
Kid, we're gonna make you rich. I mean, you're gonna make so much goddamn money, you won't have the time to spend it.
Love it. So that's all right with me.
We have a deal.
A deal, you better believe
it. I'll tell you what. First, next week, we'll get the contracts out to you and get them signed and everything, and we'll be on our way.
Thank you. I mean, wow, what can I say? Hey, oh, God, Dean, Mr. Richard, I mean, God, I'll wait to hear from you, okay?
Oh, you won't be waiting too long.
Goodness.
You know what, Mitch? Once in a lifetime, a deal comes along like this.
Now, look, I want you to give me some studio time and book it quick. You understand me? I want this kid on the charts, and I want him in the charts in a hurry, all right? And look, and get me Jimmy, all right? And get me the best sidemen they are, and I mean the very best. You hear that? Come on. Hey, Jimmy? All right, this is Mitch. Baby, have I got a diamond for you.
Seven. 33. 32. 55.
Look, I know you'd feel that I let you down. You and Mama wanted... But I wasn't cut out to be no doctor or no lawyer. Mama understood that before she died. Daddy, don't you know that music is my thing? It's a part of me. And I'm good at it. I really am. You'd have known that if you'd ever taken time out to listen. Daddy, I'm getting ready to sign a big record deal. A big deal. I mean, the whole world's gonna know me by my music. You hear that? The whole world. I said the whole world's gonna know me by my music. Daddy, I never asked you for nothing. Just to accept me for what I am. But you never said nothing. Or cared nothing. You thought that Mama worried about me so much until she died. Well, you're wrong. You are wrong, and Mama understood. Mama understood that my music was good. I'm gonna make you proud of me. You're gonna be proud that I'm your son.
Got no son.
Daddy. Daddy. I love you, Daddy. I love you. Say something to me. I just want you to tell me that you love me.
Time now for some music news that's happening today. Our headline, Local Boy Makes Good. Jesse Thomas was on his job yesterday as a working plumber. Today, with a new recording contract in hand, he has plans to retire his steel pipes and make it big with his music and vocal pipes. A new star on the horizon, Jesse Thomas writes and sometimes sings his own music. His record company is pulling out all the stops and are mounting a massive media campaign for his first new album, which Jesse says is dedicated to his father. Discos all over America are playing his music, and the kids love it. We went to a few clubs. His unique style of hard-driving rhythms has everybody dancing to a new and different beat. Jesse Thomas. We're watching this young man's career. He's on the charts with a bullet. Jesse's record company is trying something new. They made a filmed version of the title song to his new album. These music clips, as the record company calls them, will be shown on TV to help promote sales. Here's the first showing anywhere of Jesse Thomas's new song, Just the Way I Planned It.
Long time coming.
I search for day and night to find that special someone. Makes me feel so right. I know you're something special. I can feel it in your vibe. Knowing you lets me know what it means to be alive. 'Cause it's just the way I planned it. Child at Christmas, the little gift you give makes me laugh and play.
Relaxing, meditating.
Oh, God, I'm tired. I think I'm gonna hit the sack, baby.
It's only 9 o'clock.
I know.
Are you sure you okay?
Mm-hmm. I had a long day. Yeah, a long day.
What was that strange smell coming out of the bathroom this morning?
What strange smell?
You tell me.
Oh, some new aftershave lotion, I guess.
Aftershave lotion?
Mm-hmm.
It smelled like some kind of chemical to me.
Chemical?
Yeah.
Hey, Johnny. Let's take a break.
Hey, man, I ran out of Sherm.
Ready?
You got me, Whack.
Are you crazy?
Man, this turkey found out I was playing tennis. You got me, Whack? Give me some I can get rid of him. I don't know how this cat found out where I am.
He's gonna get us all busted.
I sold all my Sherms, and I won't have any till tomorrow, but I got some Whack.
Whack?
Yeah, Whack is heavy, brother. I mean, it'll get you so high you need a parachute to come down.
Is it as good as Sherm?
Is it as good? Would I lie to you, Jesse?
This is the Whack, baby, the chief angel. This stuff put more dips in your hips, more cut in your strut, and more glide in your stride. This is a monster. Get hip to the Whack.
Let me try one.
Try one. My man got stone cold cash. I love a man. Have no argument with money. There you go, brother. Hey. Mama said take a man and treat him well with his cash.
Look here, why don't you come on to the truck and we can fire up?
I don't smoke, man. Never had. No bronchial trouble, you know. Doctor says don't ever smoke.
Oh, I can dig it.
All right.
All right, John. I'll catch you later.
All right. All right. Sucker.
Jesse, how you doing? How's it going, fellas?
All right, my fans.
Where did you get those pants? Hey, Dave, that installation you didn't finish yesterday. Get out of the first thing in the morning, all right?
Just back.
Hey, Carlos, since you didn't finish that new installation.
What's the word?
Oh, net to it.
Hey, Jesse, that panel cover over the school needs to be tight. Now, you worked in it, and they're hesitant to touch it. So get out of the first thing in the morning and take care of it, all right?
You trying to say my work was no good?
Yeah, you're a real bum.
What are you trying to do to me?
What the hell was that for?
Hey, don't play dumb with me, Mr. Sims. I know you're trying to get me fired. I'm on to you. All of you! You all against me trying to get rid of me.
Jesse, what the hell are you talking about?
I'm talking about you trying to take my job away from me, man.
I'm the one who gave you the job, remember?
Hold it, Jesse! Hold it! Get your head off! Don't touch me, any of you!
Hey, what the hell's wrong with you?
Tom is supposed to be my friend! You're one of them! You're taking that side against me!
Man, that's ridiculous! What the hell's wrong with him?
I don't know, man, but I think he's on something.
Whatever it is, you better get off it quick.
Chicken or steak for dinner tonight?
Excuse me, Maestro, but I asked you what you wanted to eat for dinner.
Shut up, damn it!
To bite my head off. I just asked you what you wanted to eat.
I said shut up! How can I get any work done with you talking to me?
Just what is wrong with you?
I said shut up!
Ah!
Shut up! Shut up! Shut up! Shut up!
Let's take a break.
Boy, I can't wait till we get this. Awesome, man. I'm all in. Five slabs of ribs.
Why are they talking about me? I can hear them.
Jesse, nobody's talking about you.
Hear them.
Jesse, nobody's talking about you.
I know what you're planning to do. You think I'm stupid or something?
Jesse, nobody thinks you're stupid.
Shut up! Shut up! I know what you're trying to do! You! I know what you're trying to do, both of you! You're trying to do something to me.
What are you talking about?
I know what you're trying to do. You think I don't know, but I know. Don't you mess with me. Don't mess with me. Don't mess with me. Don't mess with me. Don't mess with me.
You say to them? Answer me, Jesse. They said you insulted them and accused them of things that didn't make any sense? Is this true?
Look, Carolyn, that was 2 days ago. I mean, how am I supposed to remember what I said or didn't say?
2 days ago, you had the chance of a lifetime. Now you have nothing. They canceled your contract.
Look, Carolyn, I don't even remember being there 2 days ago. Maybe I was drunk or something.
Get drunk. You were stoned off that stuff you've been smoking.
Hey, get off my back, will you? I mean, that ain't nothing from nothing. Everybody smokes a joint every now and then.
They smoke a joint, but they don't go through the changes that you do.
I ain't going through no changes.
Oh, Jesse. Jesse, don't you think I can see? Don't you think I can see what is happening to
you? Ain't nothing happening to me.
Jesse, you have alienated everybody. Nobody comes to see us anymore. And Mr. Sims says that the only reason you got that job is because of him.
Get off my back, would you? Look, I'm working because I'm good.
You were good, Jesse. Jesse, look. Look! Look at your hands. Look at them! Honey, you have a gift. You have a marvelous talent that is one in a million. Please! Please don't throw it away on some nonsense that's only gonna destroy you.
I don't know. I've never seen him like this before. I can't even talk to him without him getting mad at me.
I've noticed a change in him too. But he won't listen to me. And I've known him all my life.
It's that angel dust, Melvin. He doesn't even know what he's doing half the time.
Might as well be eating rat poison. They say once it gets in your system, you don't get it out.
God, I'm scared. One minute, he acts like there's nothing wrong. And the next minute, he acts like a total stranger. Melvin, please talk to him. Please, I don't know anybody else to turn to.
I'll try again. But I don't think it's gonna do any good.
There's one other thing I can't handle right now.
What's that?
I'm pregnant.
Have you told Jesse?
I'm afraid to.
Well, he's gonna find out one way or another. Better it be from you than somebody else.
No. I don't know what to do. I just feel helpless. I feel so helpless.
Vitamins and you keep your weight gain about 20 pounds.
I really enjoyed your presentation this morning.
Well, thank you. You keep your weight gain about 20 pounds and you'll have a nice, normal pregnancy. What are you hoping for?
That doesn't matter as long as it's healthy.
I know what you mean. How's Jesse doing?
Oh, I wish I could say he's fine.
Darling, is something wrong?
Yes, he's got himself strung out on this angel dust.
PCP, Jesse, are you serious, Carolyn?
Yes.
Mark.
What's what?
Carolyn, don't you know how dangerous that is? PCP is an animal tranquilizer. It can knock out an elephant.
Well, can't he take an antidote to get it out of his system?
Taking angel dust is like putting gasoline in your bloodstream. There's no antidote for that.
But
listen.
Well, what can I do?
There's nothing you can do but understand that he has got to want to stop it. And even if he does stop taking it, it can stay in his system for months, for years, and then it can come back on him without any warning. Do you understand that?
Like a flashback?
No, it's worse. It's even more violent. Come on, I want to show you this, Casey. I want to show you this. This is our PCP treatment. I wanted you to see this, Carol.
They're just kids.
Yes.
Did Angel just do all this?
Yes. Listen, it is unlike any other drug you've ever seen. It is not heroin, and it's not marijuana, or LSD, or cocaine. You name it. It just takes once, Carol, just once. And then you start losing all control.
Forever?
Yes. If he continues to smoke it.
Carolyn, what am I supposed to do? Just sit by and watch my husband fall apart in front of my eyes?
Now, unless Jesse gets into a drug-related program immediately.
But Dr. Harris, he's not going to go for that.
Then you've got to get him to understand what he's doing to himself before it's too late.
Well, thanks for listening.
I wish I had all the answers.
I'll see you next month.
Yes. Take care of yourself, okay?
How could you do that to yourself?
She's getting high.
That junk stays in your system. Jesse. Jesse, you haven't even been married a year. And you're destroying it. And you're destroying Carolyn along with it. And your music, too.
I know. Sometimes things happen that can't change. I just can't control.
You remember the first day you met Carolyn? In high school?
Yeah. She was crying because her sister's baby had died.
Take a closer look at Carolyn.
What do you mean?
She's gonna need you more than ever.
Carolyn! Baby, you gonna have a baby?
Yes.
You mean I'm gonna be a daddy? Why didn't you tell me?
Jesse, I didn't know how you was gonna accept it.
Oh, Carolyn, baby, I'm off that stuff. I swear to you, I'll never touch whack again.
Well, if you're serious,
I'm serious, baby. Look, I had a long conversation with Melvin, and he made me realize what I've been doing to myself. And to you, and and I'm sorry. I swear to you, I'm sorry.
You mean it?
Yes, I mean it.
Promise me.
I promise. I promise.
But understand that he has got to want to stop it. And even if he does stop taking it, it can stay in his system for months, for years.
This is the whack, baby.
The chief angel, you strut.
Put more dips in your hips.
More cut in your strut. And more glide in your stride.
This is a monster.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is Larry McCormick with KXDY News. We interrupt our regular programming to bring you a late-breaking story just in on our news wire. Grammy-nominated singer-songwriter Jesse Thomas was killed this evening when he ran in front of an oncoming truck not far from a supermarket where he and his wife had been shopping earlier. Now, witnesses report seeing Thomas acting strangely earlier in the evening. He's reported to have become violent and is said to have been talking incoherently just before the tragedy occurred. Well, John Singer is with our Minicam crew at the scene. John, can you give us any additional information on this very tragic event? John, are you there?
Yes, Larry. I can hardly hear you. Do you copy us here at the studio?
Yes, we do, John, but we have no visuals as of the moment. I guess there's been a problem with the transmission somewhere along the way. But, John, while we're waiting for the technicians to correct the problem, what can you tell us, if anything, about Thomas's death tonight?
Well, the entire picture isn't clear as yet. And as, of course, you know very well, the investigators on the scene are interviewing all of the eyewitnesses and will sift through all of the evidence until they are satisfied as to just what happened. But this much is known. Thomas had only recently completed a drug rehabilitation program in an effort to break his drug habit.
I hadn't heard that.
Well, not many people knew about it, Larry. His managers had very skillfully kept this out of the media. When he checked into the Project 4 program, as it is called, he registered as Thomas Jackson.
A nom de plume.
That's right, Larry. He was there for a total of 8 weeks where he underwent detoxification and intensive treatment. As near as we've been able to determine, he had responded pretty well and the doctors felt he could be released to resume his career.
Now, what drug or drugs was he addicted to?
From my understanding, Larry, it was PCP. Angel dust, I believe, is the term used.
Okay, thank you, John. We'll get back to you a little bit later in the broadcast. Now, for those of you who have just joined us, the top story of the hour, of course, is the death of singer-songwriter Jesse Thomas, who was killed earlier tonight in a freak accident apparently related to PCP or angel dust. Joining us tonight in the studio now is Miss Michelle Lewis, who is an executive with the Crown Record Company. That's the label that Jesse Thomas was with before his untimely death earlier this evening. Miss Lewis, thank you very much for coming on such short notice.
Yes. Well, it's hard to believe that he's gone. I mean, I was just talking to him this morning, and we had to reschedule one of the sessions. Jesse had everything going for him. His wife was expecting a baby, and he was looking forward to his new family.
What was Jesse Thomas like?
What was he like? He was a genius. I mean, you've heard his albums. He was just beginning to emerge as a genius.
Sure.
His last album, we didn't get to finish. The songs and the orchestrations and the arrangements were pure innovation, just pure genius.
It would have been Trade Winds.
Yes.
Yeah.
Well, Trade Winds. That's the one. That everybody in the industry said it was going to be a total flop. But even I had my concern about it. But Jesse said, hey, hang in there, you know, be cool. it'll be good. You're in good hands.
Mm-hmm. And as it was, Trade Winds went platinum, I believe.
Oh, yes. Mm-hmm. And as a matter of fact, within a month, we expect it to be a certified double platinum.
Mm-hmm. Ms. Lewis, when did the problem with PCP first become evident? When did he get hooked on it?
When did it become evident, or when did we know about it?
Well, which came first?
Well, we knew. Mm-hmm. We didn't know exactly what it was, but until Carol and his wife told us that it was PCP.
Mm-hmm.
But then we knew. I guess, you know, when things like that happen, you keep your eyes closed. You don't want to know about it.
And sure. Then,
I guess if we hadn't kept our eyes closed, we might have been able to do something about it. He'd be alive today.
Ms. Lewis, thank you very much for sharing your time and your feelings with us. And there you have it, ladies and gentlemen, our top story of the hour, the death earlier this evening of popular rock star Jesse Thomas in a freak accident that authorities believe may be related to the drug PCP.
This is Dick Ellenhorn reporting to you from the funeral procession of Jesse Thomas. Just a few weeks ago, you'll recall, we brought you the exclusive story of Jesse right after he signed his record contract. Today, he is dead.
Disappointments, you know they'll find you by and by.
This is a tragic end to a great career that was just beginning. Everything seemed to be going great. And now this.
And don't you cry. Let me tell you.
All of his many fans and friends were shocked by his sudden death. Many of them are here today to pay tribute to young Jesse, who had so much to live for.
much. There is no need to cry.
His wife was unable to attend the funeral as she was rushed to the maternity ward at Mercy Hospital.
It's a boy.
How's your blood pressure?
Put your flower down for Daddy. Thank you. Here, go play. Hi, baby. I couldn't forget your birthday. You know that. And how sentimental I am. Your father's been... He's been spending a lot of time with Jesse Jr. He wanted to do the same thing with you. He really did. You'd be so proud of our baby. He's a lot like you. Got those same eyes. Same smile. I took him last week for his first piano lesson, and he did real well. The teacher said he had a lot of talent, like his daddy. Well, yesterday I played the demo tape for him. He just danced. I played it since... Damn you, Jesse! Why did you leave us? This is so unfair. This is so cruel. I need you, Jesse. I need...
So much. Would I lie to you? This is the whack, baby. The chief angel. This stuff put more dips in your hips, more cut in your strut, and more glide in your stride. This is a monster. Get hip to the whack. Stone cold cash. I love a man. Have no argument with money. There you go, brother. Mama said take a man and treat him well with his cash. Bear a roll.
Tragic story, was it? Jesse Thomas, the man with the plan, green lights on and everything. That was a characterization, but the story was real. Now, the story said something. It said something about drugs, drug abuse. Not just about PCP or whack, as they call it. What about that new drug I talked about called crack? Death drug is just a dramatization of Lynn Bias, Don Rogers. They were real. Their tragic deaths just magnified the monster. Drug abuse. I get a sick feeling in my stomach when I think about it. What do you think that they would say if they were right here beside me? Lynn Bias, Don Rogers. I tell you what they'd say. No matter how hard it gets, no matter how much your friends tell you how good things can be, how high, you can get so high, man, that you need a parachute to come down. And tomorrow, man, we're gonna be rocking and rolling and reeling. And see, with drugs, tomorrow never comes. My name is Phillip Michael Thomas. Thank you for watching. Most important, thank you for listening.